In this video, you will learn how to use XPaths for automating websites in RPA Express. XPaths allow the bot to find elements on the web page. An RPA recorder, with the help of an XPath, the bot can click on a web element, send text to a web element, and get value of a web element or its attribute. XPaths rarely change over time, so they provide more stable web automation than images. You can copy the XPath of the web element using Firefox or Chrome developer tools. To copy the XPath in Chrome, you need to right-click on the web element, select Inspect, then right-click on the blue highlighted area. Select Copy. Copy XPath. This will save the target XPath to the clipboard. If you have changed the XPath or have doubts that it was generated correctly, you can verify it in the developer tools by pressing Ctrl F and pasting the XPath in the search box. A correct and unique XPath should be found with the result 1 of 1. If you want to see the text that will be returned using your XPath, you can install XPath Helper extension to your browser. When you press Ctrl plus Shift plus X on the target web page and paste the XPath into the query box, you will see the text in the result box. In most cases, XPaths don't change when opening the website in different browsers, so you can use XPaths copied from Chrome and Firefox or Internet Explorer or vice versa. Sometimes, XPaths copied from the browser may not work. For example, if the structure of the web page changes in different situations, or if some attributes of the web element are dynamic. Let's say we want the bot to search for a list of goods on Amazon.com, but only those whose rating is higher than 4, so the bot will need to click on the rating icon on the left bar. Let's copy the XPath of the icon and run the recording. The XPath that we have copied hasn't worked, as the XPath of this web element is dynamic. In this case, we can create a relative XPath that will always locate the rating icon by using the element's attribute that doesn't change, in this case, class. Following this XPath, the bot will search for an element with this tag and this class, which is unique. This approach is also helpful when the default XPath is too long and hard to verify. As you can see, the XPath works on all pages. Another way to create a short XPath is with the help of contains operator. Such XPath is called a partial XPath. Let's turn our relative XPath into a partial one. As you can see, the bot still finds the correct unique element on the page. Using partial XPaths is especially helpful when a part of the attribute's value can change, so you cannot use the whole value. You can read about creating XPaths manually in more detail in the XPath guide and WorkFusion knowledge base.